Republic 1818, because he understood that they would come and people would try to destroy the spirit of Constitution. So thank you, Jenny, and that was excellent. I really appreciate that. We're going to go to action items, and we've got Gayle Ruzicka. Ruzicka, sorry, just wanted to go over that.
Scott's name, it'll take you to more things than you will ever even imagine. And you nothing else. Things that you get for months, you forward them on, things that you're thinking about. And then have your friends do the same thing so they can forward those, that information. That's what works. You're still being called a telephone tree. You know, almost 30 years ago, I moved here and hardly anybody in the state even knew who Eagle Farm was. I had no idea who we were, just a handful of people did, even though there was an organization here. We put together a telephone tree. And a month after the telephone tree, we were in the newspaper. People were stopping and asking us questions. And a year later, we were considered the largest organization in the state, a grassroots organization in the state, because of the telephone tree. That was it. We did other things, but the telephone. Well, why not have an email tree, your email tree that you started? Go talk personally to your senators and representatives. Now, that is very important. Even if your senator is the sponsor of the bill, you go talk to him. You share with him this information. You invite him to come to a neighborhood meeting that you put together, and he or she, and you let them know that you're out spreading the word. And you send them ongoing emails that shows the emails that you sent out to other people. They can change their mind. They changed their mind and voted for it when 2 years ago they were voting against it. They can change their mind and start voting for it. Why they do that? Because they started getting materials from the Convention of States people, and because other legislators started convincing them, or as we elected new legislators, they got to them early and even picked out who they wanted to win. You need to be doing the same thing. Talk to your friends and neighbors and ask them to go do the same thing. Ask them to go start calling the legislator. If one person, if one of you go talk to your legislator, that can make a difference. Scott Bradley turned the legislator the senator last year, who completely turned him around with one phone call. Of course, it was one phone call, but he turned him around. And so you can do that. But then usually it takes a lot of people. You need to talk to them, and then you need to get all your friends and neighbors to do the same thing. And help them talk to them, assure them they can do it. For some reason, people sometimes think they're afraid to talk to them. Then get involved during the legislative session. You know, some of you might be able to come up and help us lobby this, but that's not what you have to do. We need you, and we're happy to have you. When we're so thrilled when you come and you can tell you we're so excited to have you there. But you can make phone calls, you can send emails, you can be talking to friends and neighbors, and you can sign up. It's very important that you sign up tonight to get on the alert list. And on this issue, this new coalition that we formed, we will send you on all through the legislative session emails that will tell you what's going on so that you know when and who to call. So get involved and do all of those things. And then tonight, we're going to, if I can see Sharon, I don't even know what happened to Sharon. Oh, Sharon, she's right in front of me. Sharon has here a few envelopes that she's going to pass on. They're donation envelopes. And if any of you feel like that you have $5 or $10 that you can stick in that envelope, it'd be very helpful and help what we're doing. We have 500 brochures out there that we just got printed today. It costs money to get brochures printed. We ran this room tonight. I think it was everything we ran was like $600. And then we had to pay for some of the extra stuff here. All through this, we're getting printing done and sending things out. And we spent a lot of money. So, if it works for you tonight or in the future, if you can donate to the cause, that would really help. Now, I want to end with just one thing, besides telling you how grateful I am that you're here tonight. Thank you so, so much. We talk about amending the Constitution and how right now the way we've done it back in the last 200 and about 30 years, I think it is, they've only passed 17 amendments. The Convention of States people want to pass more than that in one convention. But to do that, it is difficult. You know, Congress passes it. And then they send it out to states, and they have to get 38 states to ratify it. But what they're talking about now, when states call a convention, it takes 34 states to call the convention. And then all the states are invited to go to the convention, and they vote when they get there. Now, these are state legislatures. So 34 state legislatures call a convention. go to the convention, and you're all invited, I'm sure they'll all go. I don't want to miss that. And then they go back to the states, and 38 state legislatures have to ratify. And what did I just say? The state legislature calls the convention, the state legislators go to the convention, and the state legislators ratify the convention. How hard is it going to be to get 38 states to ratify what 50 states just passed? See, when it goes from Congress, they start with zero. It takes 38 states starting with zero. 1, 2, 3, 38. When the states pass it, they send it back to the states. More than likely, they already passed for 38 states. So their argument that 38 states won't let anything bad happen,
yeah.
More than that, it's Common Core. Thank you for being here tonight.